Majority Leader Mitch McConnell says under Senate rules, he would have, quote, no choice but to take up any House-approved impeachment articles against President Donald Trump. The Kentucky senator made the comments yesterday as part of a television interview. House Democrats are pushing for quick action on their probe into a transcript and whistleblower complaint that alleges President Trump pressured Ukraine's president to investigate former Vice President Joe Biden and his son. Joining me now to offer his analysis is Hans von Spakovsky, senior legal fellow at the Heritage Foundation. Hans, welcome back to the program.
Sure.
President Trump calls this impeachment inquiry a witch hunt. House Democrats are calling the president's actions an abuse of power. Knowing what you know at this point, looking at everything, is there enough there based on the words, actions of President Trump, anything to warrant an impeachment inquiry?
Perhaps an inquiry, but certainly not impeachment. If you look at the transcript of the phone call that the president had with the Ukrainian president, there's no smoking gun there. The president did not directly or even indirectly threaten to withhold funding. The other thing that I think folks are missing is it's a legitimate inquiry. Did the Vice President of the United States abuse his power to threaten to withhold $1 billion in a loan guarantee unless Ukrainian prosecutors quit investigating his son and his son's appointment to a Ukrainian energy company that paid him an enormous amount of money? I think that's a legitimate inquiry.
Going back to the transcript, as you mentioned,
yes.
The rough transcript of the call provided by the White House seems to show that President Trump urges the Ukraine president to work with Attorney General William Barr and the president's personal lawyer, Rudy Giuliani, on an investigation into Joe Biden. Is that legal?
I think it's, like I said, that's a perfectly legitimate inquiry. I think folks are, again, they're missing the point that there are indications that, why was Hunter Biden given a job being paid $50,000 a month when he has no experience whatsoever in the energy field? Was this an attempt to influence the president? And why did the vice president, why did he force Ukraine to stop a investigation by a prosecutor of that? That to me actually looks like a potential abuse of power. And why wouldn't anyone think that we should investigate that?
Rudy Giuliani has now been subpoenaed. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has been subpoenaed too.
Right.
Both men have done media interviews about the phone call and their knowledge of it. Do you think those interviews have proven to be more hurtful, helpful, or neutral?
I think it's pretty much neutral. Again, we know what was actually said. And we should keep in mind that many of the media stories about it have turned out to be wrong. The transcript, again, does not show any kind of threat. And it does show a general concern by the president about corruption in Ukraine. And that is something that folks familiar with the country are well aware of.
Well, the president says he deserves to meet the whistleblower and has accused that person of being a spy. He also accused the chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, Adam Schiff, of treason. Are those risky moves? I mean, we know Donald Trump is out there. He's willing to be bold. But could they bolster charges of him having abuse of power?
Look, the president is understandably angry about allegations that he considers to be untrue. This all sounds very similar to the allegations and his anger that he had somehow colluded with the Russians. We all know that after a two-year investigation, it turned out that there was nothing to that, that it was a hoax. So it's kind of understandable that he's angry again. What we do need to find out is, was this whistleblower complaint a partisan attempt to go after the president, or is there actual evidence of real wrongdoing? Right now, we don't know the answer to that.
Okay. Going back to your earlier point about the Joe Biden situation,
yes.
There are calls from Republicans to investigate Biden's actions while in office, obviously, as they relate to Ukraine. Do you think all of that could impact his presidential candidacy?
Potentially so, because as you probably know, that's not the only allegation that has been made against the vice president and his son. There are also allegations that his son went with him on a trip to China, an official government trip, and shortly thereafter, the Chinese government gave his firm, Hunter Biden's firm, $1.5 billion of funds to manage. Again, that brings up the whiff of potential corruption, and it seems to me that's something that we ought to be looking into.
Well, whether they're allegations or they're completely true, we'll be following it, and obviously I think they'll come into play here as we approach the next year's election. Hans von Spakovsky, senior legal fellow at the Heritage Foundation, thanks so much for your analysis today.
Sure, thanks for having me.